Nick Field, mellowing. Mellowing, Nick Field.
I am holding in my hand the key to your success. It's a marshmallow. In 1960, a brilliant scientist named Walter Mischel showed that human achievement can be determined by this. Mischel's research focused on children, 5 years old. He sat each child alone in a room with a single marshmallow in front of them. And he told them, "Now you can eat that marshmallow right now, if you want. But if you wait for 15 minutes, then when I come back, I'll give you a second one." Most kids just ate the marshmallow. Only a few managed to hold out for the entire 15 minutes and claim their reward. But many years later, Mischel tracked down his original test subjects. They'd all grown up. He interviewed them about their lives, and he discovered something amazing, that consistently, the children who could defer gratification, those kids with the discipline to strive for more, all of them had become utterly miserable adults. That's how the story began. Not the real story of Mischel's experiment, in which the kids who waited turned into higher achieving adults. No. You just heard the tall story, which I wrote for a speech contest years ago. It was a lie, but a good lie. It won that contest. And winning is very important. And like all good lies, this one has a kernel of truth. That society's winners are often not very happy. Do you know anyone like that? Think about Australian billionaires or Olympic swimmers, ex-prime ministers. So many of our highest achievers struggle with depression. They are tragic proof that you can't win your way to happiness. So why do we idolize them? How many of you have read the book, The 7 Daily Habits of People Who Are Just Satisfied with Life? Anyone? I think we need a different definition of success. At least I needed one, because my upbringing was all focused on winning. My mother was one of those tiger mums. Does anyone have a tiger mum here? Just raise your hand. Okay, you understand, thank you. But it was worse, my dad was also a tiger dad. My older brother, he was tiger bro. And me, well, my dad used to call me Tiger Balm. I didn't know that was an ointment for strained muscles. I just felt I was the rump end of the family. I had a lot to prove. So I studied hard at school. I trained hard at sports. I didn't understand teamwork or friendship. I just had to be the best. I chose a career in the financial markets because that would make me a lot of money. And money would lead to power. And power would lead to... Well, I hadn't thought that far ahead. But my new boss, Tony, he wasn't your typical alpha male money manager. He was quiet, thoughtful. He looked just like Mr. Sheen. And he taught me some really important lessons. Don't be in a hurry. Try to see what others don't see. Find balance. And learn to accept failure. He was talking about managing investments, but also about life. When Tony retired, I was more balanced. I slowed down, took up some hobbies, made friends. I learned to accept failure, just in time, because in the global financial crisis, there was a lot of failure to accept. 2007 marked the peak of a huge bubble in my ego. It had swollen up like a marshmallow in the microwave. The markets were booming. My career was booming. I found an amazing woman. She wanted to marry me. Then I got fired. If you need a lasting lesson in humility, I highly recommend being unemployed at your own wedding. But my new wife, she didn't care. I had thought she was attracted to my achievements. But she saw something I didn't see. I found a new job. But then my daughter, Percy, was born, and priorities changed. I took paternity leave to stay home with her, went from managing large amounts of other people's money to managing the nappies of one small person and preparing mushed food. It was excellent quality mushed food. But gradually, I found a balance between achieving in life and just enjoying it with people I love. This year, Percy turned 5, and she is so bright, radiant. I think she is the best, but I wanted to be sure she has what it takes. So I set up an experiment. I sat her alone in my study with a single marshmallow on the desk, and I said, "Now, darling, you can eat this marshmallow right now if you want. But if you wait for 15 minutes, then when I come back, I'll give you a second one." The suspense was unbearable. But when I returned, I saw the marshmallow still on the desk and a huge smile on Percy's face. And she said, "Daddy, I did it. Now I get 2 marshmallows. But you can have the other one. Let's eat them together." So we did. And I am happy because we both have the key to success. Madam Toastmaster.